Across Addis Ababa, the scent of coffee rises in the morning. Small stands like this one, run by Makhda Fikwi, can be found across the city. Makhda fled Eritrea 4 years ago to find work. She was afraid of what she'd find in Ethiopia and what life would be like. Her home country was still at war with its neighbour when she arrived.
There was a big difference between what we had in mind and what we actually got when we got here. The people were no different from us. They are very nice people and they treat us very well. I didn't expect this.
The United Nations estimated that at one point, 4,000 Eritreans were fleeing each month. Many of them were trying to escape indefinite military service. Eritrea maintains one of Africa's largest armies, largely because of the hostilities with Ethiopia. They began over a border dispute and led to Eritrea cutting off ties with its major trading partner.
That was a war that was not necessary. These are two countries, but one people.
In a sign of the deepening ties, troops from both nations came together in September to celebrate the Ethiopian New Year. Flights have resumed between their two capitals, and the border road has reopened.
Behind me is the Eritrean embassy. It only opened a few months ago, but it is perhaps one of the best examples of how quickly the relationship between Asmara and Addis Ababa is normalizing.
Analysts say the rapprochement could lead to a political transformation within Eritrea itself.
Now, a lot of Ethiopians are traveling to Eritrea, and some Eritreans are traveling to Ethiopia. And with this freedom of movement of people, there is also freedom of movement of ideas to some extent. So I believe whether they like it or not, Eritrea will gradually open up politically.
At her coffee stand, Makhda is watching the political developments closely.
If there is peace, everything will be all right. If job opportunities will be available, we want to go back.
But like many Eritreans, until she's certain there are reforms at home, she'll be staying in Ethiopia. Natalie Pohonen, TRT World, Addis Ababa.